If your car has a problem, you go to the garage and they dismantle and everything. They change the spare parts, and if they cannot do anything, they will just come directly to you. Your car is gone. You have to have something with it. There's no sensitivity at all. We don't care. We don't have sensitive care about cars. They're just materials. But humanity is different, you know. There is what we call holistic approach. Holistic approach means conventional medicine plays one part, you know, on the physical. But man is not only physical. Human being, there is spiritual, there's body, soul, and spirit. Like the computer, for example. You have the hardware and the software. So the physical body is the hardware. The soul is the software. You don't see, you don't touch. You don't weigh it, you know. But you see the software working in the computer, right? Same thing in us. We have the soulish part, the spiritual part, and the spiritual part needs spiritual care. So that's where faith leaders are important. If the community is strong, like Ethiopian community, we have Orthodox churches, Orthodox priests, we have Catholic priests, we have evangelical priests like myself, ministers. So we are ready anywhere to be called and to come. That's what our job is, to stand between the living and the dead. So hospitals and health caregivers should not feel themselves like mechanics in the garage. They should know they are dealing with humanity, and humanity needs a holistic approach, spiritual, physical, and soul. What I wish to, if it happens here in the care, health care departments is like, if something happens to me, if I'm dying, if my doctor knows that I'm dying, I would like him to call my wife, my friends, my family, and also my pastor or my priest. So in that kind of atmosphere, he can communicate. And the way he communicates is very, very important too. Like, you know, there are people who are told they are dying in a month, still surviving. So that means, you know, even it's days, even though their training, their expertise tells them the situation, sometimes life is unpredictable. So if I was a doctor, I would say, my expertise shows me this and this and this, and you may die. Or if that's happened, what do you want to do? How do you want, you know, in relation to your family, to your friends, what message do you want to say, you know, if this happens, if in the if clause or may is a little bit, the soft landing of the news, you know. It's very hard landing will crash, but soft landing will help the person. If a doctor comes and tells you are dying in a month, he's just like acting like a judge, you know. So a judge passing a sentence. He's not killing you, but he's telling you the truth. But the way he communicates is acting like a judge. So it's a choice here, there is a choice. The doctor, instead of acting like a judge, passing the sentence, what if he comes, you know, you are a good person, you have loving family, loving friends, you have accomplished so many things in your life, but sometimes life is short. So you are in this situation, your illness is a little bit difficult, and you may die. The prognosis and the diagnosis shows those facts, but we are here to be with you. We are part of your family, part of your friends. I am here to help you. Tell me whatever you feel. Feel free to talk to me what you feel. If he acts that way, he is telling the truth, but he is becoming part of the, identifying with the patient and with the family. That, you know, builds trust. So that connects for emotions to express, you know. So that is the way that we want doctors to know and, you know, handle a situation in such a difficult time.